A family recipe that became a classic, a Texas-sized disappointment, and a surprising win for the underdog. Get your stomachs ready as we go through the best and worst fast food chilies to order. Culver's is definitely more of a regional-based fast food joint, so don't be surprised if you've never been to one. But if you ever do stumble across one, you might want to make the time to stop by. If you're not stopping for the burgers or the custard, stop for the chili. Fans of Culver's know that they're very proud of their chili. The original recipe comes all the way from George Culver himself, one of the chain's co-founders.
He'd be there early in the morning making the soups. Chili, all the chili was made. It's his recipe, and it was still called George's Chili.
According to Culver, George's chili is, as they describe, medium spicy chili con carne made with simmered homestyle beef, diced tomatoes, dark red kidney beans, peppers, onion, and celery, along with a secret blend of peppery spices. Customers who know and love Culver's chili. Whether you eat it on its own, with fries, as a side, or take it up a notch and pair it with a grilled cheese sandwich, it's one of the best out there. The vegetables and seasonings are really what takes this chili to the next level. In fact, it's more akin to something you would expect to find at a sit-down restaurant or even in someone's kitchen after they spent hours cooking. That's exactly the vibe you get with Culver's chili. Practically homemade, but at fast food convenience and price. We all know and love Dairy Queen for its various frozen treats. The Blizzard is obviously a classic, but there are also tasty ice cream cakes, bars, drinks, and more. And then there's the food menu, filled with fast food favorites like burgers, fries, and chicken tenders, and a few more creative options like pretzel sticks and chili cheese dogs. Now, plenty of fast food joints serve decent chili cheese dogs, but Dairy Queen is not one of those places. In fact, the chili cheese dog might just be the worst thing on the menu at Dairy Queen. Food reviewers for Business Insider tried the chili cheese dog and declared that it was pretty awful. One taste tester even said that it was the worst fast food item they'd ever eaten, which is saying a lot. The barely noticeable amount of chili the employees ladled on top of the hot dog was one of its negative qualities. The chili at Dairy Queen is mild, watery, and overall just highly disappointing. Say what you will about Wendy's chili, but there's no denying the fact that it's flavorful, filling, and loaded with so many vegetables, beans, and meat that it's honestly impressive.
At Wendy's, we put more meat in our chili than most homemade recipes.
At Wendy's, we put more meat in our chili than most people put in their hamburgers.
Wendy's chili really leans into the tomato flavor, making it taste pretty fresh considering where you're ordering it from. It's no secret that Wendy's chili has become an iconic part of the menu. According to the chain, it serves over 83 million portions of the stuff each year. In fact, it was actually one of the first menu items back when it originally opened. And if you've ever had it, you won't be surprised to learn that the chili is so tasty that a rumor of a Wendy's employee winning a chili cook-off after bringing chili from work may very well be true. When you think of a sandwich joint, you probably don't think of chili at all, but when the spot in question is themed as a fire station and offers Firehouse chili on the menu, your expectations might rise just a little. After all, a Firehouse chili does sound pretty appetizing, doesn't it? We're imagining a warm, flavorful bowl of chili with just the right amount of kick, but does it live up to its name? As it turns out, not so much. Though Firehouse Subs claims that it makes its chili with the finest ingredients, including ground beef, diced tomatoes, kidney beans, and onions, it turns out the result is not as tasty or hearty as claimed. Though the subs might be good, the fast food restaurant's chili is lacking. It doesn't have much flavor, and according to online reviews, it's certainly not worth the price tag. With poor flavor and texture, it doesn't have much going for it. Another fast food spot whipping up great chili is Braum's. The chain is only located in Oklahoma, Kansas, Texas, Arkansas, and Missouri, but if you ever find yourself at the establishment, then it's definitely worth trying the chili. Not only is the chili packed with goodies, but there's a really good balance of spicy and savory elements. The texture is equally great, not too watery, but also not so thick that it feels difficult to eat. Reviewers on Twitter give it high praise for a fast food chili. Seriously, Braum's chili tastes like something you'd have at your mom's house on a crisp fall evening. At Braum's, it's served for a good price, and with a lot more side options and ice cream than your mom probably has. Sonic Drive-In has a lot going for it. Its drink menu is huge, and the combinations and creations they have are infinite. The food menu also contains a lot of items you won't find at your typical burger joint either. That said, not everything on the menu is top tier, and one dish that's really not the best is the chili.
Hearty chunks of beef, bold seasonings, winner!
I just want to thank everybody.
I don't like the way that's gone to your head.
Most of the chili at Sonic is served as a topping, and that might be the best thing about it. Sonic's chili truly tastes like the worst brand of canned chili you can find at the supermarket. It's way too salty, there's no depth of flavor, and there are no beans. Some people may like the lack of beans, but if you want your chili to be a hearty meal, beans are necessary. Additionally, Sonic's chili tastes like it's been sitting out all day, instead of slowly simmering as the spices come together. In fact, the spices are actually pretty easy to miss. It's so bland, tastes old, stale, and downright bad. The only way it's kind of enjoyable is on top of tater tots, and to be honest, pretty much anything tastes good with tater tots. If you've never been to a Steak and Shake, then you're seriously missing out. Not only does the chain serve burgers made with steak, but the milkshakes, chicken tenders, and so much more are also incredibly tasty. The menu is pretty small, so you might be surprised to learn that chili is there along with burgers and fries. Even better, it's served up in two signature ways, either alone or as a pasta dish, and it's consistently one of the most popular menu items. Steak and Shake's chili is so popular that the chain even released a canned version so that you can enjoy it at home whenever you want. Fans appreciate the canned chili just as much, with one influencer reviewer commenting, "Steak and Shake chili with beans has the perfect level of heat for me and is mild and easy to eat. The chunks of beef are large and meaty and delicious, and the beans are plump and perfectly cooked. Every spoonful is bursting with beef and beans and sauce." You might think that a place known for selling hot dogs would at least offer a decent chili to ladle on top, but that's not the case at Wienerschnitzel. While the chain's chili might serve to satisfy your craving for a minute or two, you'll soon realize that it was absolutely not worth it. Specifically, a review from Brand Eating described the chili as too salty and watery to actually enjoy, and a Twitter user said that they'd rather just eat a plain mustard corn dog instead of dealing with the chili again. Yelp reviewers described the chili as bland and lacking in flavor, and some noted the chili dogs barely even had any chili on them. Those aren't exactly rave reviews, but they check out. Wienerschnitzel isn't the place you want to go when you're craving chili, even if you just want chili on a hot dog, hamburger, or french fries. Most people associate Panera bread with soups, salads, and sandwiches, as well as pastries and assorted bread, of course. But the chili is a soup option that's surprisingly hearty, delicious, and full of flavor.
There's a lot of stuff in there.
Wait, that's actually really good.
Yeah.
Okay, I like it.
Though Panera's chili is made with turkey instead of beef, it features the same traditional ingredients as most recipes, including kidney beans, tomatoes, onions, and spices. It is also loaded with chickpeas, edamame, and tomatillos. With all of those flavors mingling, it's no wonder people are obsessed with the chili. Panera's turkey chili is so good that the brand even sells it pre-made at select grocery stores. And people love that chili too, with one influencer reviewer claiming, "If I could give it 10 stars, I would. When I first tried this chili, I didn't even know it was turkey chili, but I'm happy I still tried it because it's the best permafrost chili I've ever tried." Basically, if you're looking for a lighter chili that's still flavorful, Panera is the place to go. One of the most beloved burger joints in Texas is Whataburger. The chain serves up delicious burgers and chicken 24 hours a day, making it the perfect spot anytime you're craving a burger or breakfast sandwich. And while it would make sense for the burger joint to also sell chili, it wasn't until 2022 that it started serving it up on french fries, though that might have been a mistake. The chain really hyped up this new menu item with Whataburger Executive Vice President Rich Scheffler saying in a press release, "We're answering the call from Whataburger fans loving the new chili cheeseburger and requesting chili cheese fries. Unfortunately, the fries weren't a hit and aren't even on the menu anymore." What's more, one TikTok video went viral for criticizing the chili cheese fries as being poorly portioned. People in the comments seemed to agree that the new dish was an immediate disappointment, with one user who claimed to be an employee stating that the chili sits out for hours. Yikes, that's definitely not something you want to eat, and it's a good thing the item was removed from the menu. McAlister's is a great place to grab a sandwich, salad, or even a baked potato, but you might not know that the chili is also pretty impressive. People online love McAlister's chili, and if you've ever tasted it, then you understand why. It's savory, hearty, and exactly what you want from a chili. Vegetarians will be glad to know that McAlister's also offers a veggie chili, allowing them to experience the hearty flavor without the meat. Still hesitating? Then take a look at this rave review from TripAdvisor, because it's sure to sell you on the dish, with the customer saying, "Their chili is straightforward awesome. I've had dozens of styles and numerous chili cook-offs, but for my money, I prefer the old-fashioned style I get from McAlister's." There you have it. McAlister's chili is loaded with flavor and tastes like something your grandma would make. What more could you ask for? Another great fast food chili hails from PotBelly. While the chain might be best known for its delicious sandwiches served on fresh bread or its tasty cookies, the chili takes the cake in terms of the best menu items. Filled with beef, beans, peppers, and spices, PotBelly's chili might not sound like anything special, but it definitely is. In fact, it's so delicious that a taste test from insider food reviewers revealed that PotBelly's chili was preferred over Wendy's version. A bowl of chili from PotBelly is hearty, fresh, and has a thicker consistency more akin to what you'd make at home. Chili fans online agree that PotBelly's chili is seriously impressive. So the next time you find yourself near the fast food spot, don't be afraid to give the chili a try. It might not be what you typically order from the chain, but it's actually one of the best fast food chilies out there. And for the price and convenience, it really doesn't get better.